Have I woken up in the world of insane?
Face away from me!
Hey, citizens.
Step to the left! Kick the door shut!
Now?
Driver! Stop! What I want you to do is pull your shirt up from the top!
Hey!
I want you to turn 360 degrees! Turn around!
Yeah!
Stop! Okay, I want you to walk backwards!
We were doomed!
Shut up, slave!
I got it. Here it comes.
We have to pass the bill so that you can find out what is in it.
Huh?
Away from the fog of the controversy.
Tens of thousands of people listen to this drivel.
She's a little confused.
Shut up, slave.
Thank you. And happy 4th of July.
Bull crap.
Be quiet.
I'm thrilled to be here at Monticello. I've never been here before.
Oh, God.
We believe in free speech in the United States of America.
Hey, citizen.
You're a lying scumbag.
Thank you.
But this goes on constantly, this just malarkey that they feed the public and people just lap it up. It's really disgusting.
Oh, shut up.
Shut up, slave.
That heckler was never heard from again.
Douchebag.
You know, I'm getting a little tired of Barrett and Ward Churchill and other college professors who hate their country.
Hey.
You don't have to buy anything. You're American. You want to be a nut, you can be a nut. And you are a nut. You're like the guys who think that the space aliens kidnapped Elvis or something like that. My opinion is you are nuts.
Give him a douchebag.
Douchebag.
One, two, one, two, three. I was wondering what was in your britches.
Oh, man. Oh.
That's what I'll tell my wife.
Yeah.
Hey, hold on a second. Hold on a second.
Oh, please. Oh, brother.
Oh, God. That was hilarious.
Sorry about that.
Oh, man. Oh. This is crazy.
Sorry, I have a bad cold.
Wow. Yeah. She looks like she was chewing nails.
It's not catching, though.
We're recording right now.
Oh, you're recording. Oh, that's too bad.
Oops.
I didn't even realize that was a camera.
Yeah. Okie dokie.
So you're all for, like, yay, freedom, and all this stuff.
Absolutely.
Yay.
Absolutely.
Like, pursuit of happiness. You know what makes me happy? Free birth control.
Wow. What does that mean?
Well, I guess that's all that counts.
Yes, indeed. This is the level we've sunk into.
This is terrible reporting that this would be on, and Cameron should be ashamed of himself.
If you're looking for free stuff, you don't have to pay for.
Hello?
Vote for the other guy. That's what he's all about, okay? That's not what I'm about.
I agree.
Huh?
I agree.
Hey.
I agree.
Got a great smile, that Obama.
Shut up. Slay.
It's a sausage competition that I judge.
Oh, in like sausage eating?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
That was extremely informative.
The first way to stop this kind of stuff is for young people to be home where they're supposed to be home, and for adults not to act like idiots and assholes.
That's really embarrassing.
What could this be, John? Have you heard of this wonderful story?
Shut the fuck up!
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
I think it's become... So...
Say something.
You know what?
Yes, hello, yeah.
It's funny. It's funny because Iowans and Wisconsinites, we like to be...
Respectful of one another and peaceful with one another and listen to each other.
These ladies must not be from Iowa or Wisconsin.
Oops,
that can't be true.
This is crazy.
Hey, like I said, she must not be from Iowa.
Well, you know, that brings it about.
Brings it what? What?
Hey, all right.
Outstanding job. I'd call another PR success is what I'd say.
Exactly.
And, of course, it is the season of just getting by, so if you want to do anything, propagate this.
Our formula is this. We go out, we hit people in the mouth.
Yay.
Yay.
glad to talk to you if you'll shut up and let me talk.
Shut up!
I am not a slave to you.
Yeah.
A fraud? Let me tell you something.
Hey, citizen.
That was the greeting we got today on Valentine's Lane.
I want to be in Florida getting a tan on my back.
You shit.
Wow.
Put your hands behind your back, Kevin. You're under arrest.
No way.
Put your hands behind your back.
No. What do you mean, no?
I'm going to take you to jail.
Hey.
Okay?
Oh, boy.
First of all, okay, listen to me. You have none of this tear stuff.
Oh, really?
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have a right to have an attorney present while you are questioned.
That'll teach him.
If you can't afford to hire one, the court will appoint you one. Do you understand that?
Oh, yes, no.
Say yes or no.
No comment.
You do.
Douchebag.
All right.
That's for sure.
Tell us in the back seat. So when you stop crying and getting all hysterical, I'll talk to you, okay?
Okay, we get it.
This is the Leaning Tower of Pisa on our campus here. And the person that's built it is right around the corner here.
I don't care.
Brian Varney. Brian.
Careful that corner.
Oh, wow.
It took over 2 weekends to build. And I'm really excited because next week the Guinness Book of World Records team are going to come to evaluate it. And I'm really looking forward to that.
This is big news.
Oh. Jeez, Brian. I don't know what to say. Sorry about this. I guess we'll go back to Dale.
Yeah, no, that was really smart. Oh, God.
You know, the public is not paying close attention to the ins and outs of how a treasury auction goes. They shouldn't.
Exactly.
Shut up, slave.
Hey, do we have some fucking security in this building? Or do I have to come and pick this guy down?
Oh, perfect.
Hey, ouch, ouch, ouch.
Outstanding.
Oh, no.
You know, is it that hard to throw somebody out of a building?
I can't take this. This is off. It is one of the worst shows ever on television. I can't believe.
I'll kick your ass out of here, too.
That's right, everybody.
It's not a debate. It's a debate between us. You're in the audience.
Shut up, slave.
Hey, citizen. Yeah,
on the agenda. Black Muslim in the White House. In the morning.
Many prominent Islamic organizations wrote a letter to the White House, where they urged our White House to do a complete purge of any federal training materials from references to the ideology of Islam.
She is...
To ensure that all trainers in our U.S. military, our FBI, and other U.S. security agencies be retrained.
Uh-oh.
So they would be brainwashed in political correctness toward Islam. That's enforced Islamic speech codes here in the United States.
That's one mother I'd like to.
And all done with the help of our president.
You know, she's wacky, but I'm really contemplating giving my vote to her.
This is a woman who has a deep passion for fighting for you.
Yeah, okay. Hey, citizen.
Wow.
Staying and doing nothing is as heinous as doing it all.
Really? Oh, my God.
He's reverted back to being a boner.
All right, we're having technical difficulties.
I had guys in here who said you're full of
bullshit.
You know what?
Shut up, slave.
Already said I will not be making any comment. Oh, my God.
Bim salabim.
Bim salabim.
Buses are coming through here, too, and as I mentioned, a number of close calls, but still
police
fun to watch.
Just stopped because of your reporting. Thank you so much for ruining the fun. Total, complete killjoy.
Douchebag.
All right, well, gone on for a decade, and you've ruined
okay,
it.
Okay. Well. Douglas Zader is live in D.C. with the update on all of this. Doug, good morning. Good to see you. I guess 6-3-1, pretty much the way it breaks down, eh?
Yeah.
Maybe?
Okay.
Hello, Doug.
He's sleeping.
Hi, Doug. I guess not.
I could have one man say, we're going to tax you 25%. And I could say another.
How blind we all are.
Listen, you motherfuckers, we're going to tax you 25%.
I don't know anything anymore.
What do you mean?
You said the same exact thing.
Ooh, you're so awesome.
You said the same exact thing, but it's a different message.
And why do we care?
Yeah.
Shut the fuck up!
Oh, please.
Flight costs go up too, so we could see fewer people driving.
Spun out right behind you. Did you see that, Adrian?
No.
I know. I didn't, but now I did. So we're gonna.
Wow. Okay.
Go on it. Yeah, it looks like maybe we have gotten in an accident out here.
Really?
And probably shocked by the gas prices.
Exactly.
They've got a lot of other things on their plate.
Yeah.
So, let's. American people, the electorate in general, is stupid.
Yeah, actually, that's probably more interesting an observation.
There we go.
Shut the fuck up!
Some people in the Creighton area of Mobile say a leprechaun is taking up residence in their neighborhood.
To me, it looked like a leprechaun to me. I got to look up in the tree. Who else seen the leprechaun say yay?
Yeah! Eyewitnesses say the leprechaun only comes out at night.
And what?
If you shine a light in its direction, it suddenly disappears.
Wow.
This amateur sketch resembles what many of you say the leprechaun looks like.
You could be a crackhead that got hold to the wrong stuff.
No.
Whatever.
Gay marriage was a hot topic in Tacoma tonight. Presidential candidate Rick Santorum held a rally, and he was even glitter bombed.
How awesome is that?
I know this is a very important day in Washington. In many respects, a sad day for many people. And we saw the law signed into here into Washington State.
They were both tased. Once they were down on the ground and cut.
Everyone gets tased.
That wasn't right.
A woman was also arrested, police say, for throwing glitter at Santorum.
Well, they have such disdain and such disrespect for the electorate, for the American people.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, they're pretty much right.
Tickets are only $25. It's for charity. And you can get tickets online at Pick a Dick. Pick?
Oh, no. You what?
Well, you're thinking about sausage. So.
By the way, she's drunk again.
Pick a dick. Oh, my goodness. That was ridiculous, wasn't we it? We were not drinking wine today. No, we weren't. We weren't.
No, that's impossible.
Really it is. King of the Cabasa. So go to pickadick.com.
This is a great story.
I love it.
The best podcast in the universe.
Fucking thing sucks.
Now, will you just calm down?
Douchebag.
Give him a douchebag.
Douchebag.
He's climbing in your windows. He's snatching your people up, trying to rape them. So y'all need to hide your kids, hide your wife, and hide your husband because they're raping everybody out here.
Elaine Campbell, who became a symbol for organ donation, is celebrating her 21st birthday in hospital.
Yeah.
Anyway, onward. This never ends.
This is great. This is big news.
Turn down your speakers!
Shut up, Slay!
Keep hitting people in the mouth.
Most of our debt in the future comes from our entitlement program.
Hey, Italy, why is this entitlement program?
And Medicaid.
What? So,
I paid into that for 50 years. My unemployment and my Social Security and my Medicare. And now you're
get out of the way, Slade.
Shut up,
I hope he's taking his blood pressure medication.
he's such a shill. I mean, they're all a-holes, all of them.
Which I agree with.
Here you go.
Okay. The voting lines have officially closed.
Oh, really?
The votes have been counted and verified.
Wow. Okay. Okay, good. Let's continue.
Could you please have quiet in the studio?
Yeah.
Quiet, please.
Yeah.
Yeah, Bill.
Fucking shut up!
You jerk offs.
Thank you.
Shut up, slave.
Okay.
You know, I have to say that somewhere we went wrong in these United States of Gitmo Nation.
You know what I'm saying?
They don't blame me.
I told you, stop.
I know you love it.
Check in the window, you hear me?
Chill, man. Don't worry, it's all cool. Jeez.
You see what I'm saying?
Oh, don't worry about it.
Yeah, in the morning.
Our formula is this.
Keep hitting people in the mouth.
It was always going to be ugly.
Yeah, oh, probably.
The decision by Angela Merkel to visit this recession-racked country brought swastikas back to the streets of Athens.
Angela Merkel came to town, and I don't know if you've seen the pictures, but people literally had big signs of Merkel with a Hitler mustache, had big Nazi flags with Merkel in the middle of them.
She arrived for her first visit to Greece in over 5 years. Europe's paymaster, touching down in the Eurozone's most indebted nation.
And by the way, when you show up and there's a marching band and you're on the red carpet and you're coming out of your douche-mobile,
yeah,
your flying douche-mobile, you're kind of asking for trouble. You know, like, she's a politician from another country, but they're bringing her in like she's royalty.
That's for sure.
Yeah.
Shut up, slave.
I mean, do they think it's funny? I mean,
these people are insane. They really think they're that awesome. Like, whoop, but a ball, oh, hey,
oh. She's like a selfie, I'm eigenen Blut.
What an a-hole. Oh, no.
Shut up, slave.
This is bullshit. I'm not listening to this. You are insane.
It was a press conference without the press.
That's dumb.
Are you happy with FEMA's response so far?
I'm very happy with FEMA's response so far.
Sure looks real, but those people asking the questions at a FEMA media briefing Tuesday weren't reporters. They were FEMA employees.
How awesome is that?
Yeah.
It is all one big psychological operation.
Oh, man, that's terrible.
Completely concocted. The whole thing.
Douchebag.
Double douchebag.
Yeah, double douchebag douche douche
that. Yeah.
FEMA had given just 15 minutes notice before holding the briefing. The Society for Professional Journalists called it an abuse of the public trust, adding, what would the government have to say if reporters began impersonating federal employees?
That is a great idea.
I don't think that there was any malintent.
It makes my stomach turn.
It's pretty sickening.
Yeah.
It was just a bad way to handle it, and they know that.
Yeah.
Bull crap.
And that ends our segment.
Entrails.
How evil are these people?
I know you love it.
All aboard, train's good, plane's bad.
Shut up, slave.
Jobs, jobs, and jobs. Let's vote for jobs.
Yeah!
You jerk offs.
Yeah.
Don't look over here.
Nothing to see here.
Ooh, look at that.
Get out of the way, slave.
Shut up, slave.
It's very funny.
It's not funny.
Well, I mean, it's very funny to us.
Yeah, well, yeah, to us it's great.
Don't be a denier. The science is in. Science.
This is hardcore. This is the terror.
Number one, on the science side, we've had very divergent views. We've had dozens of experts come over the last few days and testify, giving very different opinions on the science.
Science!
Congressman, you began by denying that there is a consensus on the science. There is a consensus on the science.
The science is in!
The guy's a douchebag.
Douchebag!
You must have been listening to our testimony that we've had for the last few days with dozens of experts that have come in who have given completely different views.
Well, there
so
are
I would people, I would encourage you to go back and look at the testimony there, this committee's heard.
Yeah.
There are people who still believe that the moon landing was staged on a movie lot in Arizona.
Wow.
I know you like giving those cute anecdotes. This is not a cutesy issue. We're talking about that can export millions of jobs out of our economy, out of our country.
Man-made global warming pollution causes global warming. That's not a cutesy issue. It's not an open issue.
It's your opinion. Obviously, you've stated it many times.
Opinion of the global scientific community.
The science is in.
That opinion is the opinion of the scientific studies conducted by the largest corporate carbon polluters 14 years ago, who have lied to you and who have lied to the American people for 14 years.
And you talk about carbon, and I'm running out of time. We talk about carbon polluters. You talk about them. It's my understanding that back in 1997, when you were vice president, Enron's CEO, Ken Lay, was involved in discussions with you at the White House about helping develop this type of policy, this trading scheme.
Yeah, exactly.
Is that accurate? Is it inaccurate?
Oh, yeah.
It's been reported.
Yeah.
You should be tased.
I don't know, but I met with Ken Lay.
I must respectfully decline to answer
A-hole.
On Fifth Amendment grounds all the questions of this committee and subcommittee.
Douchebag.
As lots of people did before anybody knew that he was a
crook. And clearly, you can see why so many of us are concerned about this type of cap-and-trade energy tax that would be literally turning over this country's energy economy.
I didn't know him well
economy.
Enough to call him Kenny Boy.
Well, you knew him well enough to help devise this trading scheme, and obviously we know what Enron and these big guys on Wall Street like Goldman Sachs, and I know you've got interest with Goldman Sachs.
No.
These people
no.
know. That's been reported. Is that not accurate?
No, I wish I did.
With executives from your partnered in companies with executives from Goldman Sachs.
We know the whole thing's a scam of some sort.
Yeah. This is how insane we are in America, and this is why we are doomed.
That's where you're going to be headed if you don't start waking up.
So here comes the conclusion.
Hey, Mr. Gore, Mars has also been experiencing a global warming.
The science is in!
Since man can't be a factor on the planet Mars, do you think that Mars is global warming? This is from the best liar on the face of the planet, the biggest con man on the planet Earth, Mr. Al Gore.
Thank you. Goodbye.
The CCX, the carbon exchange, the Maurice Strong.
Shut up, slave!
Mr. Gore, you're a traitor to this nation and you know it. You are a traitor! You are subject under the penalty and crimes that are under the treason clause.
Hey,
citizen.
Mr. Gore, what's the carbon footprint of your 20-room mansion?
They're switched on and awake, and they know what's happening.
Yeah. Anyway, onward.
And a Fox News alert to begin happening now on Hurricane Sandy.
Millions of Americans are bracing for impact as Hurricane Sandy.
Hurricane Sandy threatening a massive stretch of the U.S. from Virginia to New England all the way to the Great Lakes.
When you look at what we're about to show you, you'll see why we're concerned about this storm anyway. Let's show you the deepening center of this storm as it kind of exploded in strength overnight. Look at the little dark center there.
This is just anything to get the CIA war that is going on with the White House right now and the State Department and this incredible botched mission in Benghazi off of the headlines, anything at all to do that. And that's why all of a sudden this storm is going to be the worst thing ever. Oh, it's going to be a superstorm. Because normally this would be blamed on what? Global warming. They didn't even have time.
That's a good point.
They didn't even have time to set it up. Right. They didn't have time to set it up.
Where's the global warming scam?
Now, this does give us an opportunity, John. You know it gives us a great opportunity.
Okay.
To do reports.
We got Adam Curry speaking from the mouth of the storm. Adam, are you there?
I'm God, I'm God. Hey, God, in the middle of Sandy. I'm here on the course. Hold on a second. Oh, I'm just blown over. It's unbelievable. Oh, God, God. God, I don't know who the hell my brother is. What? What? What?
Adam, where are you? Where are you right now? Well, be safe, my friend. Be safe, my friend.
Let's try it again. I'll go to you this time, okay?
Okay.
We have our exclusive team coverage right now. We're going to go to North Carolina, where John C. Dvorak. John, are you okay there? John, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm on the beach here in North Carolina, Adam. I can barely hear you. Hold on a second. I can't hear you. Okay, yeah. I'm on the beach. It's really, really bad. It's windy. and it's raining and it's storming and I don't know how much I can.
John, we're losing you a little bit. Please be safe, John. Be safe. Make sure you get to high ground.
I will do, Adam. Will do. Clip of the day.
Thank you. How kind of you.
Clip of the day.
Thank you. Anyway.
The clash reportedly happened after Iraq War veteran Walter Harvin ignored police officer David London's request for an ID.
That's right, citizens.
What kind of a deal is this?
It's a shitty deal is what it is.
Shut up, Slade.
Today, street performers gathered at various spots across the Manhattan landscape to voice their support for the effort and inspire others to take part in the Sierra Club's fight to replace coal production with clean and renewable energy. Those street performers are a common sight here in New York City.
Wow.
Crowds gathered at Union Square, Washington Square Park, and Pulitzer Fountain to watch as people
Wait a minute.
Luckily, nobody was killed.
Don't come down here because architecture. Oh, tell us great. A little bit more.
Well, the Seaport's a lot more than just shopping. I mean, It's a neighborhood, and there's so many different places you can hang out. You can just come and be by the water.
All
right. You can take a boat.
If you could stop waving for a second, we're going to show
up. Citizen, back up!
Yeah. Tells you everything you need to know right there. And,
What happened? I was trying to spread some holiday cheer.
God.
This sucks.
It's terrible.
Yeah, how can this be taken seriously?
Can you guess what that is?
I thought it was the stupidest thing I've ever seen, ever.
Here's what's even crazier.
We were sent out here to do a story. They'll do a story about what? As you can see, there's construction underway here. They've dug out a little bit. There's water has accumulated. Traffic's backed up. In a city the size of Houston, there's always traffic. So what's the big fucking deal? What the fuck are we doing out here? I ask you, what in the fuck are we doing here? Hell, I don't know.
Wow.
I think it looks great.
Why don't you just say that you have a Martian living in your bedroom, sir? Why don't you just say that?
My buddy.
Yeah.
Well, I woke up to go give me a cold pop.
Oh, boy.
But then I thought somebody was barbecuing.
The bastards.
I said, oh, Lord Jesus, it's a fire.
Hey, citizen.
Then I ran out. I didn't grab no shoes or nothing, Jesus. I'm praying for my life.
Hey, citizen.
And then the smoke got me. I got bronchitis. In the morning. Ain't nobody got time for that.
Just go. Just keep going.
You got just a little bit too close as the waves crash down on top of her. Drenched and knocked sideways by the force of water, she nonetheless managed to avoid being swept away.
She never says anything interesting, no.
Shut up, Slade!
Stupid morons. They are insane, children blood-drinking, crazy people.
Just a one-finger victory salute.
Guy was a total maniac.
It's not a big secret.
Shut up, Slade.
Thank you, Jamie. Thank you.
Don't take your cheap little pathetic shot. I am telling you that's what
you're taking cheap little pathetic shots.
Just keeping his record.
I'll tell you what the truth is. No, you're misrepresenting his record.
I'm telling the truth, sir. That's the truth about his record.
These guys are
I understand
A-holes.
What your position is not correct.
I'd like to hear why you're on satellite radio, because you can't get on regular radio.
Paul Evans, Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Bill, if you are so concerned about public figures being bad role models for children, please stop rudely interrupting your guests and telling them to shut up. Well, the shut up line has happened only once in 6 years, Miss Evans.
Oh, wow.
Asking a student to stay in the closet in order to go
I'm
to school
asking you to shut
like
up about
an African American.
No, 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 no.
Student.
Want to know what shut
I was
up.
Doing?
Shut up.
Please don't
respect,
tell me to shut up.
His respect. Why did you have to tell him you were an atheist if you didn't have any trouble reading the oath? Why didn't you just shut up? What Jimmy Carter should do is privately give Mr. Bush his opinion and shut up publicly. That would be best for the country. And it is our duty as loyal Americans to shut up once the fighting begins. Once the war against Saddam begins, we expect every American
hey,
to support
citizen.
Our military. And if they can't do that, to shut up.
Well, there you have it.
These people should be ashamed of themselves. They should be ashamed.
That's shut up. No, you had your 35 minutes. Shut up.
This is so bogus. It's ludicrous. And the fact people lap this up as though it's possible reminds me of the crazy propaganda just before World War I that was unleashed on the American public.
John C. Dvorak's pet peeve of the day.
You can't dumb down a population for five decades of television indoctrination and selling them sugary coated cardboard and think that they're now smart.
I'll see Curry's petty holiday.
Okay, meanwhile.
If you see something, say something.
We go out, we hit people in the mouth.
He didn't do it right.
I don't like the fact that he likes torturing people.
You have to see it to believe it.
Why don't you guys go fight amongst yourselves?
Well, there you go, ladies and gentlemen.
You see something, say something.
Awesome.
Yeah, well.
Anyway, now everyone's coming out of the woodwork.
Welcome, President Barack Obama and Governor Mitt Romney.
Why pay any attention to that?
We walk in and we have a beer, and then we're cool, and then we go out and we go shoot some guns.
You can take that to the bank.
No, that's... Look. First of all, there's the ludicrous...